Hello, myself Harbhajan. Today we are going to see what is J2EE and what are the steps to work with JDBC. J2EE is Java to Enterprise Edition. It is used to develop enterprise web application. The main purpose of J2EE is to develop enterprise web application. What are the things inside J2EE? J2EE consists of JDBC, servlets and GSP. JDBC is used to help web application to interact with the database, means have a proper connection with the database, because every web application needs a database to run. Whereas servlets and GSP helps web application to request and process the request and get a particular response. If we are logging in Facebook, we request the web application that we are logging with a particular user ID and password. And after processing in the database, it searches the database and sends the result, that is the response of our request. This is done using servlets and JSP. There are two types of applications here. One is standalone application and other is web application. Standalone means the application that doesn't need a connection. For example, everybody has a phone, in that there is a clock. Clock doesn't need any internet connection or any connection to work. So it comes under standalone. Whereas web application we need a connection. That may be an intranet or internet. Intranet means a private network and internet whereas public. For web application to work, we make use of a web browser. If a web browser without an internet comes under standalone, whereas a web browser with the connection comes under the web application. And how the Java and database connection is there? Java is connected to database through JDBC. JDBC is the main part through which database and Java are connected, because it is both as the interpreter, because Java language cannot be understood by the database, whereas database language, that is SQL, cannot be understood by JDBC. So it is the JDBC is database dependent, but it is also platform independent. It works in every platform, but it is database dependent. It needs database for it to work. Now let's see the overview of the steps to work with JDBC. There are 5 steps for JDBC to work. The first step is load the driver. Load every database such as MySQL or another Oracle have their own particular driver. Therefore, it is platform dependent, because every application needs its own driver to work. Whereas there is only one driver, that is Java packaging Eclipse, that is java.mysql. java.jdbc package.star to work with the data connection with database. The next step is get the database connection via the driver. As I told, the database connection needs a driver to work. So here we will get the database connection when we install the driver, which is having an extension of JR. JR, what is JR? It is a Java archive. In this contains of class and some other necessary extensions like tags and things which is need for an application. Next, issue SQL queries via connectivity. We have to issue some queries. So for that connectivity, then the SQL language should be able to be understandable in the Java language. That is the main work of JDBC, to make that both connected. Now process the result written by the SQL queries. We have issued the SQL queries that we want these results. We want the details of employee through our Java program. So it will issue the queries through this. That's because there is a connectivity. Because we have connected, we have got the DB connection. Now after connectivity, it will return some result. So it will be processed. The SQL queries will be processed and according result will be given. After all this, we have to close all the Java projects, Java JDBC objects. If we not close, it will consume more memory and it will make program and all the process very heavy. So for
not get a application gets heavy, we make use of, we have to close all the JDBC objects we have used in our program. This is the overview.